For future physicians, the USMLE Step 1 board exam is arguably the most important exam you will ever take. I'll share with you the strategies that will maximize your score. What's going on, guys? Dr. Jubal, MedSchoolInsiders.com. The USMLE Step 1 consists of 7 blocks, each lasting 60 minutes and consisting of up to 40 questions each. This 8-hour marathon is high stakes, but fear not. With the right plan and approach, you will be prepared to crush it. This video primarily focuses on the dedicated study period, which generally varies between 4 and 8 weeks. The take-home message of this video is that you need to create a schedule and do your best to stick with it. Assuming you have a sound study plan, the deciding factor on whether or not you'll walk away with a score you're happy with is having the discipline to stick with it. A quick word on scheduling your test. I had a 6-week dedicated period and I took my test 4.5 weeks in. I used the remaining 10 days to go on a cruise. And yes, it was awesome. When scheduling your test, it's important to keep 3 things in consideration. First, more time is not always better. With time, your knowledge and test score will start plateauing, and at a certain point actually start dropping as you burn out. Secondly, you want to have a break before starting the grueling journey that is your 3rd year clerkships. And lastly, do not push your test back for the reason of not feeling prepared. You will never feel fully prepared, and pushing your test back for this reason will likely do more harm than good. Now first, let's decide your resources. The UFAP protocol should be your core. This consists of UWorld, First Aid, and Pathoma. I also use Golian's audio lectures for pathology and Sketchy Micro, which I personally found tremendously helpful, for microbiology. If you are a visual learner like me, I highly recommend it. Now, pick your resources carefully. You do not want to have too many resources during your dedicated study period. You will quickly get overwhelmed and not be able to get through all of them. NBME, practice exams come into use as well, but they are not primary study resources. Onto the schedule. Creating a plan of attack for yourself is key. I made my schedule in Excel, and this is what it looks like. Don't worry, I'll explain exactly how I got to this point. You can download the Excel document down in the description below. This is what worked for me, and it's fine for you to use this as a base template, but it is important that you personalize this for your own strengths and weaknesses. For example, if your cardiology is weak, make sure you spend more time on cards. If you struggle with finishing tests on time, then make sure you do plenty of timed practice blocks to improve your pacing, and so on. My days and weeks were highly structured, and this may not work for everyone. I personally preferred this because it removed thinking from the equation. Everything was laid out and I just had to follow it to achieve a killer Step 1 score. The first step in creating the study plan was laying out my daily schedule. Each day, studying was divided into 3 4-hour blocks of morning, afternoon, and evening. I took 5 to 10 minute breaks once per hour during each of these sessions. I woke up every day at 6 a.m. as this was the time I would wake up on test day. At 7 a.m, I walked to school and listened to the Golian audio lectures at usually 1.5 to 1.7x speed. The morning study block started at 7:30, which was always a UWorld block of 46 questions. I would then review the block thoroughly until 11:30. Lunch was 11:30 until 12, and 12 p.m. marked the beginning of the afternoon study block. This block ended at 4 p.m, and I got a quick 30 to 45 minute workout up until 5 p.m. I did evening blocks starting at 5 p.m. from home, but they were broken up with dinner as my mental endurance was waning later on in the day. The first half of the evening block was 5 to 7 p.m., dinner was 7 to 7:30 p.m., and the second half was 7:30 to 9:30 p.m. I was in bed and asleep by 10. I followed this daily structure from Sunday through Friday. Every Friday evening block was for fun and relaxation, meaning Fridays after 5 p.m. I did not work. Every Saturday morning until lunchtime was reserved for groceries and laundry and whatever other errands, but I got back to studying immediately after lunch. So now that my daily schedule was determined, I went back and prioritized my study materials to organize my weekly studying. I recommend going through First Aid twice and UWorld at least once, preferably also going through all of your incorrects a second time around. I determined how many pages each First Aid section was to help me estimate how many blocks to allocate to each system. Next, fill in with supplemental study materials as needed. I had already gone through Pathoma twice before my dedicated study period, so I only occasionally referenced it. I watched Sketchy Micro videos either during my study blocks, when I had assigned myself micro, or during lunch breaks, since I did find the videos entertaining to watch. I did have an Anki deck, but I rarely used it during the dedicated study period, as this was more useful earlier in second year when I was still seeing material for the first time. I felt the application of that knowledge with UWorld questions and high-yield review with first aid was a better use of my limited time. The reason I started my morning blocks with UWorld is because I needed to get used to test-taking first thing in the morning, and I also felt like my mind was freshest at this point. I tracked how many questions I completed each day, the percentage correct, and the number of questions remaining. This was important for me because it was really encouraging to see my percentage answered correctly slowly rise over time, as well as the number of questions left unanswered slowly decline over time. At the beginning, I focused my blocks on the systems I was studying. If I was studying microbiology in first aid, then I would do a block of maybe 20 questions on UWorld of just pure micro, and then another block of mixed questions. A couple weeks into my dedicated period, however, I exclusively did mixed blocks in UWorld with all topics, as this was more representative of the actual test. Regarding practice tests, I recommend you take one towards the beginning of your dedicated study period, mostly for self-assessment purposes, and then the rest of them towards the end. These practice tests are really important. They help you get used to the USMLE question style, they hone your endurance, and they help master your pacing. Make sure you take the practice test mimicking the real environment, which means wearing earplugs, timing yourself closely, and sticking to the time limits on breaks. More on breaks in a little bit. I took my first practice test, which was an NBME test, within the first 2 weeks. I then took four additional practice tests in the 2.5 weeks before my test. I do not recommend taking a practice test within the preceding 48 to 72 hours of your actual test, as you do want to be fresh for the real deal. And yes, you should absolutely review your practice tests and see what questions you got wrong. Come test day, relax because you have got this. Be sure to check out the test day strategies video well in advance of your test day and begin practicing those principles now. I would also add that you should go in with a plan of how you will allocate your break time. If you skip the 15-minute tutorial at the beginning, you will get a total of 60 minutes of break time. Some students like to skip their first break and do two blocks back to back. I do not recommend this. Your attention span is not limitless. I instead recommend taking a break between every single block, even if that break is short. My break time was organized as 5 minutes, 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 20 minutes, 10 minutes, and 10 minutes. Shorter breaks at the beginning, since my mind was less fatigued, one longer 20-minute break for lunch, and 10-minute breaks at the end since my mind was more fatigued. I go over how to spend your break time and other test day considerations in my test day strategies video, link in the description below. Now, I cannot guarantee a certain score or outcome, but if you deliberately create a thoughtful schedule and stick to it, you will maximize your score come test day. A word of caution though, you will fall behind, trust me. I had a beautifully laid out, highly ambitious study plan, and within the first 2 weeks, I was already falling behind. But that's okay. Readjust your schedule and keep at it. There is nothing wrong with shifting things around. Be realistic with what you can accomplish during each study block, but also don't beat yourself up if you fail to achieve it. Readjust and keep moving forward. Thank you for watching, and best of luck with your Step 1 exam. For more Step 1 resources and study strategies, check out the links in the description below. If you guys liked the video, make sure you press that like button, hit subscribe if you have not already, and I will see you guys in that next one.